Let's do this thing. My name is Nick Schell. I am the living legend of hair loss. We all know this. There's no need to debate it. No one is debating anymore. It's a debate that never happened because everyone already knows that I'm the living legend of hair loss. I made a video called Receding Hairline Started Earlier Than We Realized. And that's not just for me, but for most men. I like what Andrew Moss had to say, and thank you for your faithfulness to me, Andrew. You've been watching me so long and leaving so many comments. So many videos that I've made are because of your comments. Quote, here's what he says, Andrew Moss, quote, most people are simply not in tune like the rest of us, hair loss obsessives are. So they're much more likely to see things in dichotomous terms. You either have hair or you're bald. There are many people who don't see that in between stage very easily. I was one of them. I never even knew what a receding hairline was until I was 18. Now I look back, I remember seeing receding hairlines on men as a child, but I didn't know how to process it. Perhaps I would interpret it as a big forehead, but I had absolutely no clue about Norwoods back then or anything, end quote. I think something my wife has said, because I mean, she's aware that my channel exists. I mean, she's just like, hey, and this is something that she said this week. She said, man, we just got our check from Amazon, from YouTube, $531 from YouTube. Like that, what does my wife think about my hair loss? She thinks of it in terms of dollar signs, because that's how it translates to our actual life. But anyway, something I've noticed, that if she says that a man is starting to go bald, if that ever comes up in a conversation, and usually it's not even her bringing it up, it's somebody else, but if that ever does come in a conversation, she'll say, yeah, he's starting to lose his hair. And that's me quoting her. It's like a guy that's like Norwood 4.5. Like he's aggressively balding. But I think as far as everything leading up to that, like even Norwood 3, I don't think most people really even take that into account as far as a receding hairline. It's not until you're basically bald, for all practical purposes, that people will start noticing. And I think it is true that to the rest of the world, their actual perception is not that if you show any signs of receding hairline or balding, that you're balding. It's like to the rest of the world, there's no such thing as really balding. It's either you have hair or you don't. When my wife looks at my hair, and we don't talk about hair as a thing. I mean, anytime we ever bring it up, it's only because people find out that I have a successful YouTube channel where I made $4,000 last year from it, talking about hair loss. And they hear that, and they're like, but you should have a full head of hair. That's what everyone responds with, that I have a full head of hair. My wife sees me as a guy with a full head of hair. My mother-in-law, she says, Nick, why do you wear hats so much every time I see you? You've got a full head of hair. That's how I'm perceived. I'm perceived as a man with a full head of hair. But those who obsess over hair loss will not see it that way. They're going to notice any signs of hair loss. And of course, I've made several videos to make sure that, of course, I add oil in my hair to make it look worse. But either way, when I say, hey, look at this one thing, let's talk about only one thing on this channel, then that's what you really hyper-focus on. But I think Andrew makes a great point that in reality, there's not a spectrum. It's either you have hair or you're bald. And I think, like for my wife, for example, if she says a guy's starting to lose his hair, then that's her way of saying he's bald. Because I think like Norwood 4.5 is really where that starts kicking in. That is reality. It's not about how we perceive ourselves. It's how others perceive us. Anything you believe about hair loss is true in your own mind. Yet imagine there's a whole society that has their own perception of you, and hair loss is probably not even registering on that thing. You're being judged by many other things. What are your thoughts? Right here.